Hello, today I'd like to show you how we can set up a condition activity within our Vantage process skill. A condition activity is really the idea of implementing if-then type of logic. So if certain conditions happen, we may want to do something different than another condition. So you can see here what I have in front of us is a typical setup. So we're going to input a document, we're going to extract some information from it, and then we're going to have some conditional logic that based on a certain field value within our document, after the extraction has happened, we may want to route it to a human in the loop for review, but otherwise we'll go ahead and just automate the output. What we're going to do is we're just going to add those two things here. So we're going to add a review step, and then we're going to add an output step. Okay. So let me just give you an idea and some hints on setting this up. The first thing you want to do is go ahead and put your paths in place. So I always like to just map my output step because I know that's where I'm going to go for sure. And then I'm going to also map my review step. And then I'm also just going to go ahead and finish the loop there. That way, after an item is reviewed, we would then output it. Okay. Now, if you'll notice here, when I click my if activity, I have some actions here in the action pane that says if certain conditions occur, then go this route, otherwise go to the output. So now we can get very specific in the logic to route documents to this review step. I'm going to actually share one with you. This is a pretty standard example where we will look at the document, and in this case, the first document in the transaction will find us a specific field. And as long as that field is not empty and has an actual text value in there, will return true, which really just means we're going to take this route of the condition activity. Otherwise, false obviously means we're not going to take this route in this condition activity. So this is a pretty standard script. You'll notice here then that kind of rounds out our condition skill. So bring a document in, extract the data. If a certain value exists, we'll route it to a human review. Otherwise, we will go to the output queue. So actually, let's run a test. What I'll do is I'll publish this for us. Now that I've published this for us, I'm going to go ahead and just drop some items into a queue so that the software will pick it up. So I dropped two items. One matches the condition criteria and one does not. I'm going to go to my skill monitor, make sure I go directly to that skill. And if I just look here, we'll do it here within the last 1 hour. We're going to have some items get picked up from our input source in just a second, and then the software will start its transaction. All right, so the software just picked them up. We can see here that we have two in progress. Once again, one of them matches our manual review and one does not. So the software right now is extracting the detail from these documents. And then based on our logic, we'll see how the software routes that document. Now that we're wrapped up here, you can see this first one, which matches our document, is in a manual review, and the other one is completed. If we wanted to see this document that's over here in manual review, I can simply click my manual review tab here, and we will open that document. If you remember from the script, we actually were looking at the employee ID field, and if it contained this value, we wanted to route it to human review. So that's an example of how we set up a condition activity for if-then type of logic. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, would you do me a favor and click the like button, the subscribe button, and even click that notification bell so that you can be notified when we post new videos. Thank you.